Yeah, if he can beat this, I mean, the only chance we have left is how the plumbing is. Benito, by any chance, have you guys been using lead again? Welcome, everyone, to Benito Mussolini's wet dream. That's right, we are inside of his sexual fantasies. It's kind of disgusting and sad at the same time that he ever thought he could come close to accomplishing this. Oh, that's right, we do need to refer to him as Augustus now. I completely forgot. Augustus Mussolini. But you know shit ain't changed, because he's still trying to cover up that bald spot. I'm sorry I have to say this, because every time I see this, I just think of number 15, Burger King head lettuce. To be honest, I am kind of worried this could be a horrible video. I don't know how it's going to be interesting, but let's see. I mean, they are being led by the most incompetent leader of all time. And if we're really lucky, he might get stabbed like Caesar. Now, at the moment, the factions are the same. I'm really hoping he forms his own shit, because if he joins the Axis, this is gonna be horrible. Wow, okay, well, immediately, they did just lose land to Ethiopia. So holy shit, this could be the biggest fail of all time. Oh my god, he's encircled at the moment. Jesus. All right, he's fine. We gotta keep in mind that he's gonna get stronger as every month goes by. I don't know if I needed to mention this or not, I figured it was kinda obvious, but yes, this is a formable nation inside of Waking the Tiger. Italy can reform Rome. Obviously, it's not very easy though. You gotta control all of this, and then I believe you get cores on a whole bunch of it, something like that. As I mentioned in the previous video, Adolf has a whole new focus tree, and he might be able to do some interesting stuff with Italy now. Of course, this is what we're all rooting for, but yeah, I don't think it's gonna happen. Or maybe Daddy can save us. I mean, let's be real, if he were to go to war with Rome right now, it would be a disaster. But with time, and if he helps Mao win in China, I don't know, it's possible. But at this point, I'm just rooting for some incompetent Italian AI. Which, that has been a feature in HOI4 for a while now. Now, the only thing that matters in the Italian focus tree is everything here on the right. Or at least, you know, this is all the good shit. He's staying on the left, which means he's being peaceful. I think that's a good thing. He does already have the most divisions in the world, which is scary because that's just gonna snowball. I'm really hoping Augustus Mussolini has the same weakness as regular Mussolini, which is anything in the African front. He'll just completely fail at. We got some diplomacy in East Asia. That's kind of surprising. Without any wars, the Chinese United Front just formed up. I mean, yeah, that's not gonna last very long. I think this might be the reason why. Don't do it, Adolf. Don't do it. I know you love declaring wars that you'll never be able to win, but this will be the biggest mistake of your life. You will kill yourself. Which, now that I think about it, you do already have a lot of experience with that. So it begins. We definitely need to keep an eye on this front because, again, like I said, if there's any chance of someone taking down Rome, it'll probably be in Asia. Oh, Austria said no to Adolf. That's already a pretty early slap in the face. And he's already going after Czechoslovakia. All right, maybe this is a good thing. No, this was definitely not a good thing because they joined the Allies. So there's gonna be a pointless war between these two. I should also mention Hungary is involved in this war. They didn't join a faction though. As well as, yep, look at that. We got some volunteers from Rome. What a sweet guy. Mao, why you gotta form your own shit? What is the point of this? What is the point of forming the mutual assistance block? I was trying to figure out why you did that, but then you died 7 seconds later. Hey, but the Soviet Union is somehow ahead of Rome. I don't get the logic in that, but okay. Europe is already looking cleaner. Unfortunately, there is no way for the Nazis to get to Romania at the moment. That won't last very long though. Aw, man, this is already not looking good. So Mussolini already has close to 500 factories. He is running out of manpower though, which might be a weakness, or maybe not, considering just all these damn units over here. The Danzig War is about to start up. I'm wondering how Joseph will respond. Hopefully, there it goes. What the hell is going on over here? Why this faction color change? Also, Japan is doing really well. Ah, non-aligned China's gone. I guess they got absorbed by Yunnan. Probably wasn't for the best. Expand the snilf. Do I even want to know what that means? It sounds like it would relate to milfs and dilfs or something like that. Hirohito, what are you trying to expand? Poland is already dead, and as you can see, the Soviet Union didn't get involved. Now Romania is about to die. Technically here, there are 7 different factions in the old world. It's kind of hard to tell because they're different colors, but yep, Italy's doing their own thing. And then of course there's the mess in Asia that's still going on. Yeah, I should have realized Mao didn't get killed by Japan. He got diplomatically annexed by these guys over here. Denmark was killed off relatively recently. Now they're attacking Norway, which I don't know how their naval situation's going. Probably not too well. Oh, I guess it's okay. Oh, Neptune, please, no. Wait, I actually don't know if I can say Neptune. Is it Poseidon? I can't fucking remember. War with the UK is coming, and the war in the East is already over. Japan only took one state, and then decided to just puppet everyone else. Ah, yes, I see they're going with the EU4 strategy of vassal feeding. And the nice thing about this is they finally didn't do that stupid peace deal, just taking all the coastal provinces. Oh, they do need to still go kill these guys, which isn't gonna be very hard. That'll take like 2 seconds. Unfortunately, nationalist China wasn't puppeted, which is usually what Japan does after they take over this region. I just like seeing it because there's a guy named Dong that leads them. Well, here we go. The British are about to die. Not even Churchill can save you now. I was not expecting the Romans to already get to British Raj. How the hell are they over here, actually? Africa as well is falling pretty quickly. They do need to get all the way down south, though, so that'll take some time. Greater Finland has decided that I guess Rome needs some help. Maybe Benito isn't that good. It's just Finland that's doing all the work. Wait a second. I was just playing, guys. I didn't actually expect the fucking Finnish to lead the charge. This lone division is doing it all by themselves. Look at that. Oh, we got a new US president. I've never heard of this guy. Wendell Winkle? Winky? Wilkie, I think. Well, either way, just watch out for polio. All right, yeah, it's about time. The Soviets are gonna need to die. This is clearly gonna be a fascist world. But I think the real question is, will Japan help? Because Benito's gonna be busy doing his own thing. I know that Hirohito can do something. Well, I don't know. Maybe Adolf doesn't even need him. He seems to be doing just fine over here. Well, South Africa, welcome to the Roman Empire. I don't think you're gonna last very long, even if Raj is trying really hard to save you. Oh, it's so much worse than that. Hey, you know, let's give it to the colonies. They lasted way longer than the mainland. Nope. It's a little bit too late, guys. This is not gonna help much. I realize it's really hard to tell right now, but the Germans are making small amounts of progress. Oh, it's a clusterfuck though. I don't know if the AI is supposed to be doing this. They're kind of stacking their front lines and suffering from a lot of attrition. But what do I know? I am literally the worst HOI4 player of all time. Australia is actually trying to do something. They are contributing for like the first time ever. They're over here in the Arabian Peninsula attacking this part of Rome. I mean, it makes sense. They were in their natural habitat, just a big fucking desert. Ooh, Finland, I guess is not so cool with Augustus after all. He joined the Axis instead of the Roman faction. Oh, and also this just happened. So I guess we can look forward to that. And just in case this video didn't have enough genocidal dictators for you, well, there you go. So this game just got really interesting. So as time goes by, Adolf's gonna get more and more power out of this region, which he's gonna need a lot of because Benito's kind of unstoppable right now. But at the same time, Hitler doesn't really need to worry about the allies. It's just Benito that has to fight him. I mean, he might need to start protecting Greater Finland since they're wrapping around Sweden and is gonna kill off Norway. So here's the issue. I don't know how strong Hitler is, but I'm pretty sure he's not as strong as over 1,000 divisions. At this point, I don't think the entire world could take on Rome. I mean, I can see that, you know, Hitler's trying with his military factories and he's got 342 divisions, whatever. Obviously, that's not enough. And at this point, the game is pretty much a standstill. There's no new wars being declared. Man, I really wish my Chaos AI was here. I don't like doing this, but I really don't want to end the video right here and give pretty much everyone blue balls. I'm gonna go ahead and start some stuff myself. There we go, that's much, much better. So let's see exactly how strong Rome really is. I've made them declare war on every single one of their neighbors, as well as the remaining great powers, which in turn made everyone join the Allies. Except for Iran, they surprisingly joined the Axis. Now this is obviously the single most important front line. If the Nazis fall, well, this is already over. No one's gonna be able to stop them. Yeah, don't be surprised to see them lose some territory at first. They were not prepared for me to declare all these wars at the same time. So yeah, I don't think they had their front lines drawn just yet. Augustus Mussolini was also really close to taking South Africa, but he didn't do it. He also has to deal with all the other African nations. I seriously doubt that the New World will have much of an impact, but maybe we'll see, I don't know, some naval invasions or something over here. Yeah, if he can beat this, I mean, the only chance we have left is how the plumbing is. Benito, by any chance, have you guys been using lead again? He has less than 1.5 million manpower, so there is an end in sight, I guess. Oh, and the Americans have started D-Day. Oh, they started it, and now they're, oh, it's already over. Also, unfortunately, there's like no chance for a civil war or some sort of uprising. That's kind of what I was hoping for. Damn, yeah, the Germans are not messing around. They took out Saudi Arabia, who again was a part of the Allies, and now maybe even British Raj. There it is. He officially has zero manpower. I don't know if that'll change, but let's see if he loses any land. Africa is surprisingly just as big of a mess as Europe is right now. A lot of it has to do with just the Roman divisions, but there's also a lot of allied troops. Damn, the US is really trying hard here. The Horn of Africa and the Arabian Peninsula have a lot of American divisions. This is actually the perfect situation to check out this new war window, since they've really made it so much better. Look at this. 10 million men have died for the new Augustus, mostly all at the hands of the Nazis. Holy shit. Yeah, everyone else doesn't even have close to that many deaths. The Germans are fine, and they've died from all sorts of different people. Oh, and here's another D-Day, this time made by some South American nations, Brazil and Argentina. Well, the tides have shifted, and we are seeing the slow collapse of the Roman Empire. Also, the real big issue is they lost the nuclear arms race. Hitler's gonna get a bomb first. There's the peace deal. I guess the Allies didn't get anything because they're still at war with the Axis. Either way, I think we all knew that the Germans were gonna take most out of it. Well, Benito, I really hope you savored this experience because this is the best video you'll ever have. Just like me, you'll continue to be a failure for the rest of your life. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time. And as always, big thanks to my supporters on Patreon, Elfie, Wyone, my Supreme Leader Kim Jong-un, Elijah Senpai, Jungkook's Bae, Kirby, Matthew Ellis, Rusificacion, Matthew King, and Furry Cruz. If you also want to become my daddy, there will be a link in the description down below. I promise I'll be a good hoe.